Hello everyone, I'm Jarl Karl. Welcome to another episode of my Chest Basement series. Today, you guessed it, we're going to be continuing to dig out our main room after we quickly collect some things that we had in the furnace. First, I am actually going to go to a quick stop at the pumpkin farm. After I locate my axe. I'm going to go pumpkin farming for a moment. Pumpkins will be crucial to my plan of making jack-o'-lanterns the main lighting source here in the chest basement. It will cut down an entity lag as well. The fact torches are, with all the smoke coming from them, can be quite a internet hog at times. Also, very sorry if this video is extraordinarily choppy like the last one was. That was not the intention. I hope, obviously. Just would not behave like it was supposed to. Very sorry about that. If this episode is doing the same, just feel free to let me know. I'll look at it, obviously, so I'll probably already know, but any feedback's welcome. I am trying very hard. If you have any suggestions to make this not do that, those are also appreciated. But I am trying out several different things for this video that I hope will fix the problem. Also, let me know if you can't hear the Minecraft sounds still, because you should be able to. But at YouTube, does weird stuff sometimes, so just want to make sure you can, in fact, hear the game as intended. Dig, dig, dig. Luckily placed dirt. Dirt is significantly faster to mine out. So, doing that has been, I don't know what that sentence was. Finding dirt is always a little, always nice, and it changes the monotony of digging a little bit. I get to move on to a different block type, even though it isn't really at all different. Dig, dig, dig. We got this little block narrowed out. Let me go ahead and deal with all this gravel. This isn't tedious at all. Goodness, gravel as a block is just annoying. I have all these annoying torches here getting in the way. Good gravy. Dig this little box out. Hey, gold! Always nice to find. Only four, but definitely still take that over none, of course. Well, so this digging process will continue only as long as this pick continues. Since this pick gets low on health, I will go hunt mobs or work on the grinder to make it full again before we continue work. The goal is to have this pick never break. I don't know if that goal will ever happen, but I imagine someday we will accidentally break it, but iron. We'll try not to. I'm sure there is some more coal in here too that will help repair the pick. Coal gives lots of XP, and we can always smelt stuff, which helps. There's a lot of things that will help keep this pick topped off, especially when you compare it to, although, not one, what am I saying? Although, that, the small amount of XP we can gain will not have a whole lot of use against this constant use of it, but eventually there will be less constant use of it and more XP gathering, so then, whoa. At that point in time, we should be able to keep it topped off easier. But right now, all we got is the XP that we can get from mining. This is annoying. Pond floor. Don't be like this. Part of a cave system that we found many episodes ago. Yeah. I should dig that iron out of the ceiling. We'll do that shortly. Almost done with this section. Then I'm going to head up to the surface and we can do some farming. Haven't done that in a couple of episodes, and I'm sure everything is fully grown by now, and I'm wasting out. And the brilliant set of farms that I created several episodes ago. This little block. This room doesn't seem as big as it used to be. I'm sure it obviously is exactly the same size, but it just feels like it's a different size. Fix the ceiling. Can fix the floor at a later time. How close this way are we? So we're actually decently close to the edge. Obviously not super close, but we're not that far away. Yeah, let's repair the ceiling. Really, I'm getting sidetracked again by doing this, but we'll just do this little part over. And I'll have, I don't know why I insist on doing this in boxes, but we do. So, in boxes we do it. Okay, good. And we have this little cave system to deal with. This one. Make sure I can find some coal somewhere in some of these. There's coal everywhere in this game. Dig, dig. Oh my god. Leave it, Kyle. Okay. Nice. Okay, let's get out of here. Did I put the pumpkins away? I did. Okay, we've arrived back here. Let's put that away, put that away. What should we take? What do we need to take? Let's take the gravel out. So we have that pick. That's our silk touch pick. Saving that for a later date. Okay, we'll take some of the cobblestone. And let's smelt some more of it. The rest of it in this chest. I need that back. That way. Of our torches. Put it in there. Take the flint with us. No. No. Take the flint with us. I'm not sure how many torches I think I need. And get our sword ready in case. Oh, this is all my stuff for the service, I guess. We'll take this sword. We'll be fine. We're not doing any hunting, so should be okay. Assuming that I didn't break any of the game rules or anything by mistake, there shouldn't be any mobs up here. Keyword shouldn't. We'll get our sword out anyway. And smell the dice. We'll take it. We'll have a rest. And wake up in the morning. Good morning, everyone. This is the upstairs. If you haven't watched the series long enough, this is what my normal living space looks like, I guess. Tree farm up there. We will harvest shortly. But they're in a way, I guess. So we should get, we're going to go harvest the farm, so we'll get enough stuff from that. Ah, yes, we are starting some new crops, I think. I don't know, it's been a while. Carrots, potatoes, these are beets, I think. Yes, this is beetroot. We'll just call them beets. And the seeds. Nice. So we will get slowly expanding this all the way down. Nice. So many potatoes. This isn't annoying at all. The harvesting is a little bit tedious, but then again, so is mining a giant room out, so. Breed some animals, and then we can go back down into the depths, a place we are clearly more suited to. Oh, we have to chop down some trees first. Just kidding. Don't really want the poisonous potato. Let's be honest. The carrots, we're gonna need some carrots. I'm just gonna harvest a row. I don't need a lot of them. Much faster. We need both the seeds and the wheat from the wheat. Might need two rows of this. Should really level that up. Okay. Perfect. And sugar cane is even more fun because we don't have to replant it. We gotta just do this. And it's harvested. Nice. So let's go do some animal breeding. Up in the cold weather area. A lot of sheep today. How about it is? Do these pigs first. Okay, that's fine. Seem to be short a few cows this winter. Nice. Chickens. Okay, that didn't work so well. Okay, let's make it better for the sheep, because that's where we're really going to get auto XP. That was interesting. We're over here now. Okay, all the sheep on the lead. That will do. We brought our pickup. Basically nothing. This doesn't give you all just around XP ever seen. Yeah, okay. Well, that was exciting. Sorry if I was a bit quiet there. Strange amount of focus to harvest all of those. Put these away. Do we really need any of these? Go away. Put this in here. Let's go harvest some trees. We'll probably take our saplings with us. I don't really remember what our tree farm looks like. Let's go find out. We might have we might have four kinds of trees now. No, we don't. Okay. We still only have these. That's fine. Away we go. Eventually I will need... I will slowly build up a stack of saplings, I'm sure. Do I have flint and steel up here? I feel like I do. No, I don't. Why not? This is what the chest basement chest will look like, by the way. But with full stacks and with the thing over the top. With the item in it. So we really need a stack plus one of each thing. Please don't I have some gravel somewhere down here. I already had one in my inventory. Oh, they made it shapeless, apparently. Interesting. Do you have any saplings, folks? Plant trees. Surely you can do better. Well, I'll move on to these trees, then. Where are my saplings? Seem to be having sapling problems today. Unfortunate. I believe there is a reason that this last tree is offline, but I don't remember what it is. It's already becoming nighttime. What? Okay, I'm gonna work on these because we do have a tree to burn. Okay, I do just burn down the trees that do this. So these two, the two next to it must go, and then I can burn this one. Perfect. So they have to start burning down. The wood back down to the mines where it's always in short supply. There's saplings over here. Yes, we do. A block of ice. Yeah, I'm just going to manual. Oh, wait. Wait, what? Oh, there is normally another tree in the way. Okay, these trees do grow very close together. Just don't really want the fire to spread and destroy all these other trees. I got all the saplings down, so. I guess it isn't terrible if the fire spreads that far. There we go. Made a bit of a fire line. Okay, burn away. Up. actually count jump, which is nice. Okay, so we're getting a lot of birch, a lot of normal saplings and less birch, but that's to be expected because birch do have less leaves, I do think. The run successful? Yes, very successful. No more sapling though. Come on, trees. Okay, I'll go get one myself. Wood's coming back with me. That's staying. Should be fine. Let's descend back to our lonely mines. Fresh supply of wood, though, which is nice. Always needed. Down here, whether to make charcoal or make shovel handles or whatever it may be. Usually these days it's, is charcoal. Nice. What, 1052 to 10, okay, so it doesn't really gain a whole lot. Yeah, and up probably a stack of blocks that I can mine, just because of the way that works. Look at that. I do have a wood chest right now. Burns. Let's get some more charcoal. Fuel the fires. Okay, so, oh, we do have a bunch of these saplings too. And we have spruce saplings. Nice. Put the pumpkins there at least. Nice. Put that out. Put some of the iron in there. Go somewhere else that goes. Actually, that doesn't go anywhere else. Don't keep doing that. Can't put the axe away though. There we go. Would like to get a little bit more mining done in this episode. I think I will level this out and then I'll call it a day. Indeed, call it an episode. Go across here. Nice. Actually sure if this will break into something. Actually, yeah, it will. Breaks through here. Goal is to have this room completely dug out by episode 20. So the next couple of episodes will be pretty heavy mining, as I just go ham on the mining. I'm decently close. There's clearly still a lot left, but there is some hope at the end of the tunnel, so just want to push hard and then get the series actually underway. But we are closer than it looks, I think, to being done with this digging project. Still a good bit to go, but I would say we're... I don't think we're half done. We might be. There's a lot already dug out by caves in the stuff that I have left. So there's some that's just dug out for me already. Jack-o'-lanterns and carpet is the flooring plan that I have for this. I think it looks really nice. It's what's lighting the, like, this walkway is lit with, these are all jack-o'-lanterns under the carpet. It looks very smooth because there isn't any visible light source. Or maybe some cool pattern on the floor that I might put down with jack-o'-lanterns. I think it might look pretty cool. Or maybe different colored carpet. I don't know. I'll think about it a little bit. Probably during the next episode I'll think about it. Best source of XP is mob kills, and the best source of XP for that is through a grinder that I should make. Also, going to the Nether, because if I believe it's a skeleton spawner that we found, and quick kills on those are done using potions of healing. It's the quickest way. Just do a drop grinder, and instead of having to stand there and hit them all with a sword, I can just sit there with one healing potion, just drop the healing potion, and stand there holding the pickaxe. And watch as XP comes flooding into my pick. And I shouldn't have to do that very often. Obviously, you can tell this pick is sustaining itself very well. Could repair it with diamonds as well, but obviously I'm not mining for diamonds, and I would be using up a limited resource in diamonds, so don't really want to do that. I was going to end the episode, but I think I will. I am going to dig on for a little bit. Again, there's a lot of progress to be made, and this looks like a nice place to make it. And I'll be done, but a lot of series have built up to them. This is just the build up to mine. Just dig this all out on creative mode, but that seems against the spirit of what we're doing here, so I am going to do this legitimate and hope that you will bear with me on the journey. And if you aren't into this kind of thing, as a lot of people wouldn't be, feel free to skip ahead probably 5 or 10 episodes and we will be doing much more exciting thing, many more exciting things then. But it feels like the game is recording better today. Very smooth on my end. I may have gone too far in one direction with the settings. If that's the case, I will certainly be adjusting, and much adjusting will be going on between these episodes as we get back into the swing of recording content again. But, you know, the sticking out doesn't actually take that long. Each block obviously goes, you know, if I was still doing this with iron pickaxes, yeah, this might seem non-impossible, but rate that we're going at, it all gets done pretty quickly. Sure what Unbreaking 3 does, like, mathematically. I think it, I'm not sure how much more life it gives it, maybe, I don't know. I think that maybe there's a 25% chance that the pick will break every stroke. So each durability might be like 4 blocks, not sure. But it does seem like we've dug out an awful lot of blocks, and it has endured very, very well. Every task we've set of it. One more effort. I would like to get through digging out this room without having to stop and make the mob grinder. I would like to do all of that after I'm actually set on the series. Emerald. Hype. And occasionally we do find surprises inside the walls. We got 2 from that and some XP, which brings our PX health to 802. We will go take some stuff out of furnaces and put this cobble away, and then we will be done for this episode. This cobblestone chest is filling up in a hurry. This is done. 802. 880. So that's a decent bump. That was perfect. Nice. Decent amount of that left. Whoa, mouse. Behave. Anyway, that's going to do it for this episode. Thank you all. Watching, I think we got a lot done. I'm sure it wasn't the most exciting thing to watch, but I'm glad that we got it done. A couple more episodes, hopefully we'll see this room completed. There's one edge of it. We can see, go ahead and stand in the corner. Should be able to see all the way across. Yep, that way. Down there, that way is a little bit obscured. I fog, but hopefully with render distance increases, maybe possible in the next episode, we will be able to see all of it. Anyway, that's going to do it for this one. I hope to see you guys next time. Till then, Take it easy.